Good morning and welcome to BOTB HQ in Parsons Green, South West London. My name is Christian Williams, a presenter here at BOTB, where we're here this morning to judge the latest midweek car competition, which ran from the 14th to the 20th of January 2021. And just before I hand over to the lawyer this morning, once again, a massive congratulations to Mike Wareham, last week's winner of the midweek car competition, winning a brand new Mercedes CLA 45S AMG shooting brake plus £10,000. I'd now like to pass over to Robin Cumming from Onside Law, who'll oversee the proceedings this morning.
My name's Robin Cumming from Onside Law, and I'll be overseeing the judging process this morning. Firstly, I can confirm that the competition data has already been sent to the auditors as ETS. I would now like today's judges to introduce themselves and, using the secure link provided, mark on the screen where they think the centre of the ball should be. The group will then come to a final panel decision.
Good morning, my name is Alain Gomard. I'm an ex-professional footballer, having played for Paris Saint-Germain, Newcastle and Fulham.
Good morning, my name is Aaron Mendonca. I've been involved in football for over 30 years, firstly as a player and then as a referee.
Hi, my name is Kieran Fitzgibbon. I played football for more than 30 years and I'm now a senior county referee.
Hi, my name's Renee Hector and I'm a football player for Watford FC Women and I'm a coach for Tottenham Hotspur Foundation.
Hi, I'm Matthew Ray. I've affiliated in multiple counties across England, currently in Gloucestershire, and have refereed from grassroots through to professional academies.
Good morning, my name is Andy Braithwaite and I'm a football referee, mentor and licensed observer.
Hi, I'm Jenna Scalacci, former professional footballer. I'm now head coach on a college programme.
Good morning. My name's Roger Wheeler. I'm a referee and I've been refereeing and lining for more than 30 years.
Good morning. My name's Matt Cannon. I'm a senior county referee and footballer.
Good morning. My name is Leo Donnellan. I'm an ex-professional football player, having been with Chelsea, Fulham and Leyton Orient.
Judges, please now come to a final panel decision. For your reference, the larger white cross is the calculated average of the 10 individual selections.
Thank you, Robin. So on today's picture, we've got two players challenging for the ball. I think the ball is coming up towards the player in green. He's looking up diagonally. So personally, I took most of the information from this player. The player on the right with the red and white shirt, I think, is looking quite low. Looking at the body language, it looks to me that the player in green is kind of reversing towards the player in red and white, who's trying to block him. And I'm not sure if he's going to head the ball or if he's going to control it. I'm going to start by drawing a few lines. Yeah, we're going to do both sides. I think they're looking slightly in a different direction. Oi. And I'm going to take some lines for the player at the back also. Okay. We got a quite, I would say, narrow, not so narrow band actually from both angle, but it's a bit spread, you know, in the width. We've got a, you know, like a little cluster, I would say, of four crosses. We've got myself and I think Rene plus Jenna, who's not too far, and we've got I think it's Roger, Kieran and Leo a bit, you know, further on the left. So I'm going to start with Roger. You know, you've indicated the center of the ball, you know, the furthest on the left. Can you explain what your thoughts?
Yes, Alain. I mean, I agree with what you said about the two players and what they're doing. I just thought the player in red, you know, he seemed to be quite laid back and had a good eye line, good view. The ball is coming towards the green player, and again, I just felt he's got his eyes wide open there. He's going to play the ball, but I didn't think it was absolutely, you know, imminent.
Okay.
So I'm not as close as several of the others.
His
body language to me was, you know, there was still a little way to travel.
Right, okay. So did you take into consideration the player at the back there?
Yeah, as I say, I thought he, you know, he seemed to be a little bit, what should we say, calmer and
okay.
have a better panoramic view, if you like.
Right. Okay. I see. On the other side, we got Andy, who is quite close to the player in green. Can you explain, your position?
Thanks, Alan. My take on this particular one was that the ball was quite close, judging by the guy in green. His mouth, the actions of his mouth is almost like an intake of breath that the ball's, to me, quite imminent. The guy behind him, red and white stripes, his eye line doesn't look as if it's, you know, to me, that far away. He looks almost startled, as like he's coming quite close. And that is basically my point on where I think the centre of the ball should be. I just thought it was a little bit closer.
Okay, so you thought the impact was imminent?
As I said, whether it's impact, maybe sometimes we get carried away with he's going to head it, he's going to do this. I just think that the ball is there, whether it's, say, bounced up or whatever. But I just feel that he's got it under control and the ball is literally just in front of him.
Right, okay. Okay, thanks, Andy. You know, a bit higher, we got Rene, who is, you know, just on top of my cross. So you thought, you know... You know, if you compare with Andy, that the ball was a bit further to the player in green.
Yeah, well, to be honest, I feel like in this picture, there's only one player here that's going to win the ball. I think the player in red and white is a bit of passive defending and hasn't really got any interest of getting stuck in there. So I didn't take massive amount from his eyes because, similarly to Andy said, I feel like he looked quite startled, so I felt like the player in green's eyes were, I could take a bit more from them, but yeah, I felt like the contact to the ball was relatively imminent but not quite on top of him, I've just gone with mainly with the eye line of the player in green and how far away I felt the ball was, really.
Okay, thanks, Rene. So what I'll do, for the time being, I'm going to remove Roger and maybe Kieran. Kieran, actually, can you explain your position? It would be interesting to, you know, to see what were your thoughts.
Yes, thanks, Alan. I think, a bit like Roger, I think the ball is coming into the player in green, like everybody said. But I feel that given the position of the player in green, he's got his right thigh raised horizontally. I think he's backing into the player in red. I think I've taken a little bit from the player in red because I think the ball's coming in at pace. That's why I think it's a little bit further away and a little bit lower. I think the player in green is not going to head the ball. I think he's going to play it with either chest or lower down with the body. But I think he's backing in towards the player to play the ball. And I just felt because the ball's coming in at pace, that's why I placed my cross a little bit further away.
Yeah, I do agree. Yeah, he's backing towards his opponent. Yeah. Leo, you are, nearly the lowest, I would say, and you are one of these three crosses, on the outside. Can you explain your thoughts?
Hi, Alain. Yes, I think the player in green obviously is just going to sort of hold the player in red off. I think what I did with the player in green's eye line, I think he's obviously looking forward and he's looking upwards. But he wasn't looking so high. So I just think the ball's in front of him and a little bit above his eye line.
Right. Okay. Thank you. So, for the time being, I'm going to remove Roger and Kieran and see, how the average moves. It moves slightly on the right as expected. And between these two little cluster, we've got Leo, further, slightly lower. What I'll do, I'm going to remove the lines and just put some lines, towards the average. And the player. Okay, I don't think that this player is looking, that high actually. So as it is, and if I put the ball on the, on the average, this is what we got. Matthew, you are, in the, part of this little cluster of four. What do you think at the position as it is, regarding, if you look at, the eye line of the player in green, mainly?
Yeah, I quite like where it is. If I'm honest, I've gone mainly off the eyes of the player in green. I think he's looking quite up. I think we're all actually quite similar in how we see the player in red. We've only really got one eye to go off. So I'm happy with that in terms of how the player in green's looking.
Okay. Thanks, Matthew. What I'll do, because as we've got, we got a narrow band, coming from this player in green. What I'll do, I'll remove Leo for the time being to see, how it shifts the average. Yeah, it's very, very slightly. I'd like to hear about, Matt. So you're the closest, from the average. What do you think about, the average as it is?
Yeah, I personally think it looks better with Leo removed just because we've got this narrow band of the other seven judges. And I think it's important. I mean, Kieran pointed out that the guy in green has got his leg up, and we've all said he's sort of backing into the player in red. So, and the ball is in the foreground coming into the player in green. I think the player in red and white behind him is obviously, he's trying to fend him off. He's got his hand wrapped around his midriff and he's pulling his shirt. So I think his eye line, which I think is lower than this blue line here, has shifted from the ball to actually self-preservation, where he's now started to look at the player in green, and that's his main focus. And Rennie put it succinctly earlier that he's not going to challenge for the ball. He's a bit startled, I think, as a couple of other people said, and just protecting himself. And the ball in the foreground, I think, with the seven of us, with Leo removed, it's such a narrow band, and it's just that how far the ball has got to drop into the player in green. And I think it suits his eye line better, but that's my own opinion.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for your explanation, Matt. Jenna, what do you think, about the average, where it is?
Yeah, I think I agree with the seven. So keeping it without the cross that's a bit lower. Yeah. I think, as everyone said, the guy in red, I think the player in green's got him locked in. He's got no chance of winning that ball. I think the player in green's backing into him. And I don't think he's going to head it. I think he's going to get it down and control it. So for me, I think that band in a diagonal line is a better average for me.
Okay. Also, you know, thank you, Jenna. I think what we have to bear in mind also is, you know, the ball is, you know, comes slightly as on an angle. You know, as you can see, his head is, you know, turned slightly to the left, and so it might be slightly in the foreground. Ari, I haven't heard from you. What are your thoughts?
Yes, I feel that he works better as well without Leo Cross in this situation. I felt that as you guys said, Blaine Green is backing up, and I believe that if he doesn't have a poor first touch, he will be in control of this situation. He will have options, and his facial expression tells me that the ball is quite close to him, and he's gonna control with his right boot. That's my vision.
Right. Okay. So it's coming quite steeply.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, Ari. I think we need to we're going to proceed to a vote. You know, whether I think we keep Leo in or out. So, in the average is as it is, and out it shifts slightly up and to the right. So let's start with you, Ari. So, are you happy with or without Leo?
Without Leo.
Okay, thank you. Kieran?
I think Leo should stay in.
Okay, thank you. Renee?
Without.
Matthew?
Yeah, seeing it, I think it looks better with Leo without.
Okay. Andy?
I actually think it's probably better to keep it in myself.
Okay. Jenna?
Without.
Okay. Roger?
Yeah, sorry, Leo. Without, I think.
Matt, what do you think?
Yeah, without.
Okay, thank you. And Leo, I guess you would like to be in?
Definitely in.
Yeah. Okay, I'm afraid, you know, following the judgments, we'll have to keep you out. So let's remove all. Okay, Robin, we're going to judge with the average without Leo, Kieran, and Roger. That's our final decision.
Thanks, Alan. If you're all happy, then please click submit. Thank you, judges. The coordinates selected are 1115808. These coordinates will now be passed to the auditors as ETS to calculate the winner of the competition, and they will then inform BOTB. That concludes the judging process. Thank you.